Please join me in saying the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of
the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Nurtured, encouraged, and even nudged your student. let's be honest, you drag them kicking and screaming to make sure that they are part of this senior class. Our students' accomplishments are the result of this partnership, and we thank you for that. I would like to recognize some special guests who are here with us tonight. Seated on the stage, we have Mr. George Ricks, our school board member from District 4. And we also have Dr. Robert Sharp, who is Assistant Superintendent at Hamilton County Department of Education. Thank you. Let's enjoy this special evening.
The class of 2016 would like to present CSAS with the gift of new and reconstructed front steps leading from the back parking lot into the main entrances. The steps have been a hazard to many on their entry into the school, and we hope these new steps will improve the look and feel of our beloved building. The new steps will also be accompanied by a plaque to commemorate the class of 2016 and our time in CSAS.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to begin to take a moment and thank the school board, Mr. Bowles, all the faculty and staff at CSAS, as well as the graduating class of 2016, for giving me this opportunity to speak before you today. It is an honor and privilege to represent the class of 2016 on one of the most important days in our journey as students. It has been 4 long years at Chattanooga School for the Arts and Sciences. I remember my first day at CSAS. I was very nervous, and I remember all these unfamiliar faces I had never seen before. It took some time, but I began to make friends and meet some of the teachers. Before I knew it, I was beginning to get a grasp of CSAS. There is something about the atmosphere and the people here that make it such a unique school. The teachers and staff at this school are some of the most caring and sacrificial people I have ever met. Their dedication to this school is phenomenal, and they have a huge impact on the students. I've gotten a chance to meet with many of the teachers, and you have all had very positive impacts in my life. Many of you students have been here from kindergarten all the way until now, and know almost every teacher in the school. Some of you came later in elementary and middle school, and lastly, some of you, like myself, came in during high school. No matter when we began CSAS, we can all agree that we are grateful that we decided to continue our journey as students at CSAS. It's amazing to believe that we are almost done with high school, and even school in general. We have devoted much of our lives into the school over the many years. To put that into perspective, we have been in high school at CSAS for 4 years. There are approximately 180 days of school each year. We have been in school for over 720 days. So at about 7 hours in school day, we have sat in the classroom for over 5,040 hours, which equates to about 302,400 minutes. Long minutes. And that's the equivalent of about 210 actual full-length 24-hour days we've been in the classroom, give or take the many snow days that crept their way in. And that's a lot of time that doesn't even take into consideration the many hours spent doing homework, studying, practicing, and working on projects. In this time, we have changed so much. We have matured over these 4 years into the people that we are today through the many events that we have been through. Along the way, we have learned to become independent and are learning to rule our own lives and knowing that we will be on our own in the near future. With these have come new responsibilities when we have learned to take control of the many things in our lives and have experienced new moments where we must be self-conscious of our decisions. We have all worked very hard to get to this point, but we did not do it ourselves. There are many people in which we owe a huge debt of gratitude for all the things that they have done for us. Just as William Arthur Ward once said, feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. So today, as the class of 2016, we are here to return our gratitude to you. First is to our parents. Parents, thank you for supporting us in more ways than we can count or imagine. Your job as a parent was simply to provide food and clothing for your student each and every day. But you went way beyond these simple necessities. You were the ones that dragged us out of bed and functioned as our second alarm clock after our first one failed to get us up. You provided us with school supplies and lunch money, so we were prepared for our school day. You herded us out the door and drove us to our bus stop or school yourselves until we were old enough to drive ourselves. You helped us with homework until it got too complicated. You paid our class fees and willingly listened to our complaints. You showed up to performances, attended our sporting events, chaperoned our field trips, and joined us in student-led conferences. You sympathized with us over our daily dramas, but gave us enough space for room to learn and grow. You should be proud, because you have parented a child who is about to graduate from CSAS, one of the best and most challenging schools in the county. You have helped us become successful and reach this important day in our lives, but these are just a few of the thousand ways that you have supported us on this journey. And with that, we thank you, parents. Next is to our principal, vice principal, office staff, and Ms. White. Your job at CSAS is to enforce the rules, log hours for people, and collect data. Your role is mandatory for our school, and you take control of the aspects of the school that keep things running smoothly and cooperatively. With you, all the teachers have a much easier time teaching the students with no headaches, and we thank you for that. But we also thank you for being strong role models for our school. Although you are the authority of the school, you also take time to meet and relate with us. We thank you, Mr. Bowles, for reminding us to find what makes us tick. We will always be in pursuit of the things in life that drive us and define who we are. And we will never forget your wise words to us. We thank you, Dr. Gaines, for the many times you would walk down the hallway or enter a classroom and bring smiles to many of our students' faces. Your character had the ability to brighten up our days. We thank you, Ms. White, for all the responsibility that you showed us. Although you were serious when it comes to your work, you also took time to encourage and build us up. And to the rest of the office staff, we thank you. We know your job entails many monotonous assignments that can be less than satisfying, but we can sense your appreciation for us and the pride that you have in the school. We thank you, Mr. Bowles, Dr. Gaines, Ms. White, and the office staff for how you used your abilities to change the atmosphere here at CSAS to make it a heartwarming place to be. Next, to our guidance counselors and college advisors. You are the ones who have kept our heads straight to get us on track for graduation to be here today, and we thank you for that. You have helped us find our next step in our education to pursue our lifelong learning. Much of your time was centered on how to make life simpler for us students and our parents, and we cannot thank you enough for the many workshops, meetings, and college visits, as well as our senior boot camp. Without your help, some of us might not be graduating today in this pursuit of lifelong learning. Majority of your job is to keep records, watch our credits, and to mail our transcripts, but also you also devote your time to us. You always have time to take a moment and talk to us so we can share a life story with you. Many times it is not easy dealing with life while trying to graduate high school, and you lent your heart to us. I know that if I needed help with anything, that I could have walked into the guidance office to get a moment to take a breather and talk to someone. You opened your heart to all of us and were unselfish with your time. You made us seem important and encouraged us to reach where we are today with your sincerity. We thank you, guidance counselors and college advisors. Next is to our coaches and advisors. Your duty was to bring home the win for the CSAS Patriots. A winning season meant a chance to be district champions and you pushed your team to try their hardest. Although you have high expectations to become victorious over the other teams in the district, you also find opportunities to build the character of your athletes. We thank you, coaches, for making school more than classwork and homework, but rather a chance to focus on aspects other than academics. Through our sports and athletics, we learn to power through adversity and give our best effort every time, whether we won or lost. We learn the importance of discipline and what it means to have good sportsmanship through the many games, competitions, and matches that we played. By participating in many other activities such as clubs, performances, and service projects, we learned how to work together as a team to reach a common goal, and still had a lot of fun while doing it. We thank you, coaches and advisors. And last but not least, to our teachers. This includes all of them, from our math and science teachers, to our history and English teachers, to our art and music teachers, and to our foreign language teachers. We thank you for unselfishly sharing your time, talent, and knowledge with us. We know it is your job to teach us, but you have poured your life into each and every one of us. You took time to explain concepts and assignments, sometimes repeatedly because we were not paying attention or we were trying to stay awake in class. You gave us opportunities to meet with you in your classroom before and after school for help when you could have spent that time doing what you want. You put in the effort to create assignments that would push us beyond what normal high schoolers are being taught. You created assignments that challenged and inspired us. We all remember some of these memorable assignments, from the power to the people, to the biology debates, to the American dream, to the many art projects, to the musical performances, to our midterm, to our senior project, and all of those in between. You demanded excellence from all of us, whether or not we wanted to give it. You facilitated us in seminars to push our understanding and build our communication skills. We will always remember the many times joining together in a circle of chairs to discuss the many pieces of literature and artwork. Whether it was a roast for Emily, or To Kill a Mockingbird, or The Hills Like White Elephants, or the four paintings titled The Voyage of Life, we will remember them all, and the values behind the themes of those pieces. Your job is to teach us, but you desire to inspire us, teachers. Not only do you want us to learn in the classroom, you want us to learn beyond the classroom. You inspire us to take our learning to the world around us, and you have molded us into lifelong learners. We thank you, teachers. As you can see, we can attribute much of our success to the dozens of people who have impacted our lives as students here at CSAS. Everyone in this room has built us into the people that we are today. Their years of dedication cannot be overlooked or discounted. For all the time we put into our journey through high school, so have all these people in this room. We're all different people with different positions and responsibilities, but together we are a family. We are the CSAS family. And as a class, we owe them a round of applause for all their efforts. And so by now, we're almost out. We are minutes away from moving from students to alumni. The feeling is bittersweet. No one ever wants to leave their family behind, but an opportunity knocks. We have all been called to a new step in our education and life. College is our next step from here, and we are all nervous and excited at the same time. But we must never forget the impact CSAS has had on us. All of our teachers pouring their life and time into us in the classroom, all of our parents with the moral support they gave us, all of our principals and office staff for the leadership they uphold, and all of our counselors for all their contributions to our next steps. We must not forget the great times we spent at CSAS and the friends that became our family. No matter where you go or who you become, you must not forget where you came from. This school has impacted us all, and it will always be with us. And in our final words as the class of 2016, we say thank you.
Good evening. Well, I guess this is part of the program where I'm supposed to give this inspirational speech about moving on to bigger and better things. Into some of all of our high school days into a speech lasting only a few minutes. However, I believe that it's only fair that I start by saying thank you. Thank you to the faculty and teachers who gave us mountains of homework, knowing that we were going to wait until the last minute to do it. But still not giving up on us when we were oh so ready to give up on ourselves. Thank you to the parents who stood over our shoulders through every project and paper that we tried to get done also at the last minute and saying, are you done yet? Isn't this paper due tomorrow? Now you know that if you had started when I told you to, you wouldn't be up all night trying to get it done. And lastly, I would like to thank the class of 2016. Thank you for being your crazy selves. Thanks for always staying true to yourself and for not letting any other person change that. Okay, so here's my overarching cliche. High school is like a journey. Sometimes it isn't always about the destination, but it's the road it takes to get there. And when it comes to high school, no one said that the road would be nice, straight, and paved with gold. A speedway every few exits where you can grab a slushie or pick up some snacks when you need it. And to grab some cheap gas without having to worry about being stuck on the side of the road. However, the reality is that the road is never like this. There are going to be some bumps in the road and times where you don't quite know if you're going to make it to the next gas station. But you keep going because you want to make it to your destination. You want to make it to today, and let me tell you, we made it. The wonderful thing about being at CS is that your journey doesn't have to begin your freshman year of high school. Despite the year you came to CSAS, that is where your journey began. I still remember the start of my journey, my first day here in first grade. I got dropped off in the back and hopped out of the car with my white K-Swiss shoes, my Tommy Hilfiger sweater, and to top it all off, I had a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle backpack with the wheels! I was styling and profiling, couldn't tell me nothing. I mean, but what could I say? I was all that and the bag of chips. But the problem was that there were about 100 other kids who were thinking the same thing. I mean, plus we had snack time and recess. We had it all. Elementary school just wouldn't be the same without the friends we made. But it was the way that we made friends that was very interesting. A lot of stories went like this. Wow, you like Power Rangers? I like Power Rangers too. Best friends? Best friends. And then you two have a falling out because at recess you both wanted to be the Red Ranger. I mean, but it's cool because 5 minutes later, your best friends will be here. Whenever we think about elementary school, you can't forget about all the trips and the little activities. One of my first experiences is when we had our body fair in first grade. Now, it was the nastiest thing I have ever seen or smelled in my life until that point. There were pig brains and fish stomachs and intestines, oh my! But I had to admit, it was the coolest thing I've ever seen. However, they didn't have anything on our performance of 1-2-Step by Sierra. And it was at this moment that I knew that this school was going to be great. And that a lot of people did not have a career in anything involving religion. Then we got to secondary. Now remember two things. One, this is the year that we start the dreaded TCAP testing, which will plague us for the rest of our educational careers. And two, the spider play when it stole off. Now, in the play, I wasn't the spider. And honestly, I can't remember who the spider was, but what I do remember is that not only was I an elephant, but I was the best elephant you ever did see. Can't tell me nothing. I was a prodigy. Then next year we had another play, but this one was in a foreign language. Okay, now I could barely remember my lines in English. And now you want me to remember something in Spanish? The play was Snow White, and unlike last year, they didn't just give us our roles. We actually had to try it out. And I was sitting there dumb, kind of like, do you not know who I am? I was elephant number one in that spider play. You said I had to audition. So I auditioned for the most important role in the play, the prince, or El Principe. Because who better to play the best than the best? I put everything I had into that performance. And it ended up being amazing, of course. So I run into the success of the show all the way into the end of fourth grade. We went on our Nashville trip. It was our first overnight trip, and we were ready. We had our PJs, our sleeping bags, and most importantly, our Nintendo DSs. Pickup chat was the texting of our times. And it's definitely the reason why we are able to our phones and text into our new group messages today. If you didn't have a DS, then you knew someone that did. And that was all we needed. And pretty much sums the entire trip, except for the museum. It was like the Creative Arts Museum, but better. A lot better. The next year, though, was the climax of our elementary school. We were in fifth grade, so we were already the seniors of the Borough School. And we got to go to Temple High. This is the first year where we were on our own. No parents would tell us to get up and I do this and I do that. Although first we had to make the trip down. Here we are, a bunch of kids on a bus, early in the morning. So we weren't really that tired. We were probably too excited to rest. I'm pretty sure we watched High School Music on repeat the entire way insane. Undoubtedly led by Coleman. Yeah, the trip was educational. Like I learned what bioluminescence was. But that didn't matter. I got to see a dolphin. Make snores for the first time. Just have a great time sitting around the campfire. Overall, elementary school was pretty much smoother than the fast lane. It was a smooth ride, but as you all know, all good things don't last forever. Now, high school, all the years to remember. But, I guess I need to talk about the years that should not be named. If life is like a journey, then middle school is the time where to start. You have no clue where you're going. Your phone is dead. So you pull up onto the side of the road to ask someone for directions. And the only thing they did was get you even more lost and put you on this old path that's not even a road anymore. It's just dirt. You're just hoping you make it out alive. That's middle school. A year of bad decisions. I don't believe that there's one person sitting in this auditorium that can say that they just love their middle school experience. It isn't just us. We've all had to go through that awkward phase. These were the years where we tried to find ourselves and realize how strange we really are. First, there was the hair. Now, the guys were pretty standard. We either had the low and even, or we had the beaver cut. But the girls on my band were an entirely different story. Just too many bitches. In the end, the best part of middle school is leaving. It's said to be the best 4 years of your education. Now, we're in the last few miles of the trip, so we start getting a bit excited. And when we get excited, we start speeding down the road, happily leaving the dark, unforgiving town called middle school, and getting back on the road towards our graduation destination. We still have a ways to go, and the best way to travel long distance on the highway, because the speed limit is high, and they're pretty much straight for the most part, which is a huge step from the barren dirt roads of middle school. Although to get on this new highway, there are about 30 new drivers in the road that are trying to merge into the same highway. Merging? This was not on the driving test. We've never had to do this before, so we're panicking, they're panicking. It's not a pretty sight. Plus we're stuck instead of speeding down the highway with the sun and high. But anyways, like I said, we're excited for our last 4 years of high school. Mainly because we were told that we're getting a whole new class this year. Now, if we got one new person a year, it was enough to throw a party. But an entire class? We didn't know what to do with ourselves. It gets boring seeing the same old faces every day. It's the same as getting a 4-4-4 at Wendy's every day after school. Yes, that'd be good. I mean, it's always been good. But maybe one day you want to try to switch it up. Get maybe the homeless one day or even hit the little Wendy's. But we're excited nonetheless. We never had to deal with so many people before, so we were lost and began to evolve back into our old middle school ways. And began to rely on cheesy pickup lines. And I hope he realizes now that, can I take your picture so I can show Santa, what I want for Christmas? Doesn't actually work. It felt like we were back in middle school all over again that first year, and that was something I was not willing to repeat again. Knowing this change is a big one. The administration had the bright idea to pack a bunch of 14-year-old strangers on a bus and send us to the Ruby Falls zip lines to bond. Now, I was under the assumption that they were just going to put us in the air and we were going to zip. But no. They couldn't just let us zip. That would have been too easy. First, they had to do an entire ropes course before we got to the real one. Not only did they haul us in the air, but they also put us on these itty-bitty string. That was the only thing keeping us from hitting the ground. So as we were maneuvering the course, I had two people by me, one in front and one in back. I had Destiny behind me telling me that I could do it. And Travis in front pretending that I was taking too long. All I knew was that I was not going to be the one to follow. Not good day. So I just kept the tiring on until I made it to the zip line. And then they told us to jump. Now everyone in here, including myself, knows that due to gravity, if you jump, you will fall. So this is why we're heading to the jump off of our safe platform. The only thing we could do was to contemplate on how we made it to this point in our life where we're going to willingly jump off the platform. So mid-contemplation, He felt his hand on my back, expecting that we're going to get a few words of encouragement. But no. The same hands that we thought were here to help were the same ones pushing us off that platform. This event proved to be fun, but it also, in a way, gave us a glimpse of how our next few years will be. Yeah, it'll be a lot of fun, but there's going to be some work involved. And if you blink, you might just miss it, or hit the ground. Sophomore year was a blur for the most part, and this is the part of the journey where you don't realize what's going on around you, because you're either too sleepy or too focused on your destination. We pretty much had a lot of schoolwork that needs to be done so we can maintain or bring up that good GPA that we need for junior year. Because this is the year where things get crucial. We have ACT, college trips, and American Dream, and other stuff on top of that that we had to deal with. But before going on college trips, I had absolutely no clue where I was going to college. I was more focused on what we were going to eat for dinner that night. Nevertheless, I had a great time, and I saw many different colleges. The trip opened our eyes to all of the roads we had in front of us. All we had to do was choose one and keep going. The overall experience was memorable, because we had many stories and many laughs to share from that trip. That struggle of fun didn't take away the fact that we still had an American Dream speech for once we got back. As interesting as it was, many of the students here can attest that it was an incredibly stressful time. Now, honestly speaking, I think it should come with a warning label, like in those medication commercials. Warning, while working on the American Dream, one may experience tears, attitudes, bits of hysteria, and even occasional vomiting and or fainting. Thank you, and have a nice day. Now with this knowledge, we probably would have been more prepared, because we knew that this was a huge pothole in the road. But we didn't truly realize how big it was until we hit it and we're driving down the road with a bumper tractor behind us. In August, we were almost there. We almost reached our destination. And we can see the sign, graduation, 20 miles. You can see the city on the horizon coming into view. But the worst part was that we also saw the traffic piling up as well. We tell ourselves that all we had to do was keep going. And we could. Except for the fact that the gas was on empty and needed to be refueled, but we kept going. Why stop when we're almost there? Then comes the infamous senioritis. We just didn't care anymore. We just trying to make it to the end. This year was going to be perfect. Easy classes, senior skip day, open lunch. This is our school now. And on top of that, we thought we were invincible, because just like in kindergarten, you couldn't tell us nothing. We came into senior thinking that this is going to be a breeze, and we could just walk into the building like we owned it. Now, we could just kick back and let the time roll by, but they were all lies. The only thing I have to say about senior is that we were played. Hoodwinked, bamboozled. Either way, they did us dirty. It wasn't until after the first day that we realized what this year was really going to be like. First, there was Miss Bella. Now, she was the sneaky one. We started out the class doing a bit of analysis, a short essay here and there, did some meditation. And it was all fine and dandy until she smacked us with that midterm. That monster. Now, I was so hurt. Now, I thought we were cool up until that point. And then we read Hannah in class, which honestly was a lot of fun. So I forgave her for what she did then. Then once again, she did us dirty. She gave us 10 essays to do once we were winding down our first semester. The last time I was hurt, but this time I was devastated. I couldn't even get into my usual Christmas spirit and sing my carols and all that jazz. I was just filled with so much pain. And then there was Singing Project. I don't even want to talk about it. It was something else. The deadlines, the paper, the confusion, and the procrastination. All of that blended together to make a row. girl's final semester. We just had to face the facts. More of my death is the same as just three more miles. We had to keep going. So I was able to weigh in the pros and cons of not doing the project every day up until my final presentation. But by then it was too late. I already had it done. In the words of the great Forrest Gump, that's all I have to say about that. Although, through all these dire moments of stress and despair, we still had a bit of fun. Our basketball games were the premier event of the season. I'm pretty sure our team was great this year thanks to the leadership from the seniors on the team. But the real show didn't happen on the court. It happened in the stands. The student section was both hype and reliable. We showed up and showed out at every game, unless it was way out in the middle of nowhere. We just didn't have the gas for that track. However, when we were at home, we ran the show. Because this is whose house?
His house!
Right. And last but not least, it was prom. First of all, ladies, I don't know how y'all come to this notion, but prom is not the equivalent for a wedding. Yeah, it should be nice and all, but you don't need to be expecting a red carpet with a horse and carriage waiting to whisk your way to a ball. And I also don't know who came up with the word proposal, but that needs to stop. Good time. Well, let's see that. Like, y'all are looking for a ring and a commitment. And plus, nowadays, it seems as if prom is more for the parents. Because I don't see why you have to take 50,000 pictures from the time the child wakes up to the time they walk through the door. It's not that crucial. But nevertheless, it's an overall experience that I'll never forget. Be able to remember for the years to come. Now, my day wasn't like this, so we had a great time. But I remember because that was the last stop on our journey. It had to be. We spent all of our gas money on tuxes, tickets, dinners, flowers, a rental, and gas for the rental. So we might have been a car, but we kept walking down the road. But after all that, we're here. Our GPS tells us you have reached your final destination. Our entire journey so far has led us up until this point. Although there were times where I didn't think I would be here, I'm pretty sure many of you thought the same thing. We're here. We made it. We got lost a few times. Left the house a bit late, almost ran out of gas, tried to kick everyone out the car, and there might have been that one person who does it out of every song on the radio as if it was their own. Because if you don't know our struggle, then you can't feel our hustle. But know that no matter what happened, we can all say that we made it to today. But the fun thing about going on the journey is that once you get to where you're headed, you're ready. These next few summer months will seem like the best. But if you go on the journey, you'll eventually have to leave and make your way back home or to the next stop. So from here on out, my path may no longer be the same as your path. They might intersect, and I will get you to the intersection to your next stop. However, the most important thing to remember is that we keep moving forward. The senior quote says, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. And if you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Whether it be in the car yelling your 16th birthday, the minivan you have to get later in life, after you're married, of course, or the red sports car you get when you're going through your midlife crisis, keep moving forward. Within these halls, we've had some of the best experiences and have made the most amazing friends. Now, these are the times that we'll carry with us throughout the rest of our lives. The friends we've made, the lessons we were taught both in and out of the classroom, the connections we made with our teachers, the laughs we had, and most importantly, the memories we've shared. We spent many years at CSLA and or CSAS and with our friends there. And due to this, it's going to be hard to say goodbye, because this is pretty much all we've known for most of us. It will be hard to say goodbye. So instead of saying goodbye, we'll say until next time. So to the faculty, administration, parents, family, friends, and most importantly, to the class of 2016, until next time.
Thank you. Bateen Barnes.
Elise Edwards.
Nisha Lachey Holland.
Thank you.
partner.
Thank you.
close. Graduates, it's been a long road. Each year I set goals for our school. If you look back over the past 3 years, I've set goals for you to celebrate what makes you tick, to encourage you to serve your community other than just yourself, to celebrate diversity, and this year to promote unity. As I told last year's graduates, despite our efforts, I'm not so sure we're achieving our goals. However, if you look around, I'm not sure the world is meeting those goals either. Your senior year has been surrounded by just as much tragedy this past year, both nationally and right here at home. Our goal to treat others with respect and to show personal dignity and to develop a sense of unity is failing all over, but also can be seen right here in our own backyard, from the terror attacks on our own military facilities to the current count of 66 shootings across our city. What's scary is just a couple of weeks ago when I started revising this speech, we were only at 51. That reality makes our goal even more important. It has to change. You see, you have the power to change the world. One person at a time can do it. If it doesn't begin with you, then who does it begin with? We want you to know who you are. Your teachers and family want you to respect the passions of others just like you want your passions to be respected. We want you to celebrate diversity. We want you to think about someone other than yourself and go out into the community to serve, with you being the furthest thing from your mind. And while we might not have fully achieved that, all the goals that we need to keep reaching for them. You might be scared about what is next because it is a scary place out there. But I'll leave you one last thought before we go. Here's a quote from the great writer E.E. Cummings. He says, "It takes courage to grow up and become who you really are. It takes courage to grow up and become who you really are. Know what makes you tick. Know what you really want to be. And have the courage to do what others might not. You may just change the world." Congratulations to all of your graduates.